Today I wanted to make the announcement that I have made a community residence determination for the Sri Lankan family that has been in held detention on Christmas Island to ensure that they can be reunited in the community in Perth. In making this decision, I'm conscious of the compassionate factors of having children in detention for a prolonged period of time versus ongoing litigation matters before the courts, matters before me as Minister that will take some time for us to resolve. In doing so, this will ensure that the children and the family have access to services in the community, health support, schools, other forms of support from the government and the Australian people while the final matters are being resolved. I want to say from the outset this has been a complex matter. It has taken several years of litigation and other matters to resolve. We still have some outstanding processes in front of us that need to be resolved. They will be resolved. But the Australian Government makes clear in everything we do that we are not weakening our resolve on our border protection. And why that is important, because anyone that has arrived by boat will not permanently resettle in Australia. Or anyone who is an IMA, no matter what the status of their case, whether it comes to the public attention or where it doesn't, and we have to remember there are still thousands of IMAs in different cohorts, can lead to a restart of the people smuggling trade. If the people smugglers see a weakening in the border protection stance of Australia, they will restart the trade. And these are a family of IMAs in the parents who in 2012 and 2013 came to Australia by boat. The government's position has been clear that no one will permanently resettle in Australia who has been an IMA. Right, so the community residence determination I made today is a form of community detention. The family agrees to certain conditions. They are allowed freedom of movement within Perth. They have to reside at that location. The accommodation is provided and access to schools and other support services is provided. And there is a range of agreements to obey the law and to obviously meet certain conditions. Look, the conditions of the community residence determination I've made are standard conditions that apply to community residency. Now, I don't believe they're onerous. They agree to abide by certain conditions. They get provided accommodation, healthcare, education, other support services as appropriate and in line with community expectations. And the conditions they agree to are normal conditions applied with common sense for a family in this situation.